I always would say I wanted to be a doctor, and then everyone would say, oh yeah, you could treat us, and I say, no, I don't want to be a doctor that treats you. I want to be a doctor that actually makes new treatments. So here I am. My name is Kapil Bharti, and I'm an Earl Stedman investigator here at the National Eye Institute at NIH.
You can see it lighting up all of these cells.
I run a group on studying and understanding how retinal degenerative diseases happen and trying to develop new treatments for those diseases. One is called age-related macular degeneration, AMD, and it is a disease that affects millions of people worldwide. One of the main tissue we work on in the lab is a tissue called the retinal pigment epithelium, the RPE. They actually help the photoreceptors, help the retina, they nourish the retina throughout its life. The RPE cells actually die off in AMD patients, and as a result, their photoreceptors are dying, and because of that, they start losing vision. This is one of the Allen Institute's reporter iPS cell line. The Allen cell collection has been the most beautiful thing that I've recently seen. How do these cells actually polarize? So when I say polarized, they acquire this three-dimensional structure and they define their own locations. And nobody knows how that happens. No cell biology has looked into it because there was no way to look at it. And once I saw this announcement from the Allen Institute, I was like, this is it. This is a way to do it. We're doing live imaging of every single organelle, and then we're going to do 3D reconstruction at every time point so that we have a complete understanding of where the organelles are at a given time as the cells are polarizing. We at the same time perturbing those to see what would happen if the cells were unhealthy, how would these organelles behave. One of the main goals has been to develop a cell therapy for patients with AMD. And the idea was to deliver a patch of RPE cells made from patients on iPS cells. So this has been a work that we're now trying to put together for a phase one clinical trial that we hope to submit to the FDA soon. Really, my hope is that combined together, all the knowledge, all these new tools that we are creating will bring new treatments, even perhaps new cures for these patients.